right, everybody, welcome back to the channel. This is Rob here at Smirking Interviews, back with more Dark Season 2. We're on Episode 2. It's called Dark Matter, so full spoilers if you haven't seen this episode. Sorry it took so long to get this done. Been busy working. And quickly, I want to address a couple of things. There's been a couple of problems in the comments section. I'm going to give them the benefit of the doubt for the minute and say that they put up a spoiler and had been admonished, and I foolishly forgot to take it down. I don't even remember what it said, because while I like this show a lot, it's so complicated that I don't even know if I would have recognized it as a spoiler. But somebody else did notice it. They said I suck for not taking it down. And while I will admit that I should have taken it down, I don't know if I suck because of that. I might suck for something else, but I don't know. And then another commenter and this same person that spoiled something kind of started to get into it. So that person's on the person who put the spoiler up is on their last warning. To keep it cool in the comment section and not downgrade anybody in there. It won't be tolerated by anybody. You will be muted and removed. I want everybody to have a good experience here. And so that's it. That's my piece on that, okay? So let's move on. Also, I want to thank Belinda R. For really going to town on Twitter to talk to people about Dark. So I think a lot of people kind of owe her finding this review, or you guys finding this review, a lot of it is owed to Belinda's work. And so I just want to thank her very much for all the effort that she puts into keeping show communities together. And so now let's get into this. Now, I took a lot of fucking notes. Because this is, like I said in one of my other reviews, and probably all of them, this show is impossible for me to just review like a normal review of mine. Because I don't like being on a script. I like being unscripted and spontaneous. And so it makes it a little harder to feel like I'm being myself. But we're going to start tonight with a certain section. And we're going to deal with the Titlemans. So the Chief Inspector Titleman, Mrs. Titleman from the nuclear power plant, we're going to deal with all that stuff and Ulrich stuff as well, because it coincides with Titleman's storyline. So first off, I love that they have Ragastly playing, but would somebody please smack Regina? Oh my God, I did not want to hear her name called one more time. Regina, Regina, like when she just comes walking out of her room like, hey, hey. I wanted to put her through a wall. But we also get the dog thing that's becoming very hard for Mrs. Titleman to not talk about, that it looks like her dog, it seems like her dog, it's her dog, but until she gets to meet herself at work. Now, this was pretty cool because she meets her older self. And so I guess in this universe, they're not playing by Back to the Future rules, which is, if you meet yourself, you pretty much unravel time and space. So no unraveling, no time unraveling in this. So at least that's something. Also, Titleman, Inspector Titleman doesn't tell her that he's dying. So again, this show really should be called Dark Secrets, because that's what this is. It's like they're dealing with dark matter, but like Jonas says, like, this is all because of fucking secrets. And just another one, like, him not telling anybody. Like, it's that whole, that sitcom bad, that drama moment on a TV show where everything could be fixed if you just tell somebody what you're holding back. In this case, it wouldn't be fixed, but it's still, it's just like, how many plots are there where just people not telling each other what they think? And she gets told by her older self that some things have to happen exactly as they happened, otherwise they can't change. So I am assuming then later on that there's going to be something that happens that's going to put that little lock into place, and a whole bunch of things are going to are going to change because of it. She's supposed to stop Adam, so I'm assuming Adam is that melty face guy from the first episode of the season. And I also love her line that life is just a collection of wasted opportunities. It's part of it. I don't think it's just that, but she does have a point a little bit. And then we find out that Titelman finds Ulrich in the nut house. He's been there for 34 fucking years. That really sucks. And of course, Titelman's there. You know, I arrested you 34 years ago, like I said in the first season reviews. It's like they're destined to just be cop and robber, except they're both cops. But I do, again, with the crypticness, though, he's like, hey, man, what's going on? He's like, you're just too stupid to understand what I'm talking about. Because he says, all I want to do is kill many lives, as many as I can. And I don't even remember what that was from myself. But he said it to him when they arrested him. And I'm going to have to, like, have somebody in the comment section remind me about what that is. He says that everybody gets what they deserve. So I guess he's referring to himself, too, that maybe he sees how he lived his life and kind of deserved to be in a nut house. I don't know. I don't think 34 years worth of... I don't think he deserved to be 34 years stuck in a nut house. And then Mrs. Titelman finds what was buried... Okay, yeah, let me see if I follow this sentence I wrote right. Titelman finds what was buried by her future self in the past. And it's a time machine. So now she's got her hands on a time machine. Next, we're going to talk about future Jonas, Hannah, and Mikkel. 1 second. All right, so poor Mikkel, he realizes that it's his mom's birthday. He's stuck in 87. His mom is a bitch in 1987. Pardon my French. But a lot of people that age, we were all a bunch of little bitches, okay? So it wasn't just the girls. But, you know, it's his mom's birthday, and he has to realize that he's stuck here while his mom's out there in the future, you know, looking for him, and he's concerned about that it's her birthday. And then when he gets to see her at school, he's reminded that his mom wasn't always the nicest lady. But the, you know, the nun is really trying with him, and it's great to, you know, it explains so much. But I want to know why he killed himself, though. That's the thing that's bothering me. Is he got, you know, he clearly, you know, him and Hannah got married, they had kids, and for some reason he had to kill himself. So I'm thinking that that's got to do, has to be something that has to happen, which is, I don't know, that's nuts. And then Jonas takes Hannah to the cave so that she can understand Mikkel's secret, so that she can understand kind of the gravity of everything and what's going on. And it's, you know, Mikkel feels it when he's out there in the woods. Like every time somebody uses it, they know. But for some reason, Noah knew to be there. And that's kind of like, why was he there? Why did he know to be there? Or was he just like to hang out in front of that cave? I mean, he did say he likes to come out there a lot, but right at that moment, kind of creepy. I did like, though, Mikkel asking him, like, you know, what if God doesn't know what he's doing? I like this kid. And then Hannah, later on in the evening, you know, they get to Mikkel's house where he's being taken care of, and Hannah has to realize that that's, you know, that Mikkel from the present got lost, went back to the past, became someone else because he was the only way to survive, and meets Hannah and marries her and has Jonas. It's all fucked up. There is a story in here also about Magnus, and he's mad at his girlfriend who he thinks is prostituting herself off, but really she's just like selling or dealing in hormone therapy drugs. And then young Regina's hanging out with Andrew McCarthy, because that's what I thought he looked like. Or he kind of looked like the guy from Stranger Things. So that's that part of the story. And then what else do we have to talk about here? When they talk about Regina describing her meeting with future Jonas, and they find Jonas's paperwork, which all leads Catherine or Charlotte to tell her husband that this is the stuff that my grandfather was working on. And he's the guy who built the time machine. And so they're all trying to figure out all this stuff. Things are starting to make connections where everybody's bigger stories are starting to reveal each other and come more into focus that it's all connected. And then I'm leaving it off for Jonas in the Den Zone. So 1 sec. Okay, and right off the bat, first off, the girl. Was she one of the kids that went, did she go missing too? I'm having a hard time remembering everybody. So, and I again apologize, and I thank the community for explaining a lot of stuff for me because, with everything I watch, it is just really hard sometimes. But he's in the dead zone trying to stabilize the dark matter, and it's really cool. I mean, the effect is something that we've seen a lot lately, but it's still pretty dope, especially when it gets into its solid form and it's still moving around. That's pretty crazy. And dark matter, I mean, this is one of the coolest ways that they've ever dealt with dark matter on a TV show before. On a TV show, they are really trusting its audience, and I honestly feel like this show makes me feel like German people are definitely smarter than Americans in some ways, because the shit that this show would not get watched by anybody in America, unless it starred like unless they had like a cast, like a really well-known cast, because this is a complicated ass show, and people in America, unfortunately, most of the time, well, look how long the Kardashians stayed on TV, and we elected a reality show person as our president, so we got issues over here. Jonah's distraction with the record and bringing everybody out, drawing all these soldiers out just to get some gas, but balls on this kid. I mean, Jonas is, I don't know if he's earned the right to be this smart yet, but I mean, I'm just going with it. Jonas is a badass, and brave as fuck. Because, I mean, he gets caught by, Charlotte's deaf daughter in the future, who looks great, by the way. That whole look with the dead eye and everything, just fantastic. And I like that just because, and I'm sure that there are reasons for the deaf girl. I can't remember her name. That's why I'm referring her to as a deaf girl. That she is the way she is. But it's nice to see that, like, what we see mostly with people with handicaps is that they're always portrayed as like the best people or like people that you're supposed to feel sorry for. And I like that in this character is complicated enough to be like, well, she's kind of a, she's a bit of a problem. But she doesn't kill Jonas. She wings him in the leg, which, God damn it, like, poor God, leave Jonas alone. But she doesn't. She shoots the rope out, and they lock him up, and then the girl lets him go, and they go to the dark matter where he's trying to get back and save everybody, because of course he is. And he makes it through, and it's pretty crazy. And hopefully, this was a coherent review. I wanted to spend some more time like thinking, I wanted to make more Back to the Future references because I was going to say, Mikkel's handling going back to the past way better than Marty McFly ever did. And this kid's like a little kid. So you got to give it up to his definitely his, I don't know, his moxie is the only word I'm thinking of. Like his ability to adapt to his situation is a lot better than a lot of adults would probably handle it. So anyway, that's episode two. A lot to talk about. There's so much more in here that I, little things. There's a few things that I definitely didn't talk about, but mostly because I was having a very hard time following it. But anyway, if you liked this review, please hit the like button, comment, share, subscribe, all that jazz. Otherwise, we will be back with episode three in the next day or so. So either way, in the meantime, this is Robin Smirking Gun Reviews saying have a great night, and we will see you next time. Bye.